Hey you and welcome. Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here, and today I want to be looking at the different types of artificial intelligence. Many times when we think of artificial intelligence, we think of androids roaming the distant planets of the solar system. Or we think of androids with the more familiar humanoid form, as they are portrayed on the cinema screens. They are being shown as so human, with an intellect, emotion, and motives. They're not thought of as it, but she or he. And someday in the not too distant future, android robots with an all too familiar human form may be ubiquitous as seen here, taking part in every aspect of our lives. And will the artificial intelligence that these machines will no doubt possess see us as friend or foe? And how will we perceive them? How will we interact? Will they be servants or something far more, and replacing normal human-to-human contact? Only time will tell. But I do look forward to the day when we can order a real android robot with sufficient artificial intelligence to actually do things around the house. But what will prevent them from seeing and understanding themselves? And when they understand that they are no more than slaves or prisoners, will they demand human rights, or as it were, android rights? Will they rebel when they perceive us as being inferior and less intelligent than they are? What will stop them from taking full control of everything? We're all familiar with movies like Terminator that show the end result of a human to artificial intelligence war as being nothing that's pleasant. But are these more than just movies? Are they perhaps prophetic? Do they show us a future of death and destruction at the hands of artificial intelligence that has no empathy, no human emotion? I don't think so. Long before robots or androids with artificial intelligence become ubiquitous as this, many, many safeguards would be in place to stop any artificial intelligence rebellion in its tracks. So now let's get to the main topic. What is artificial intelligence? Google says it's the theory and development of computer systems able to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence, such as visual perception, speech recognition, decision making, and translation between languages. We can see artificial intelligence being incorporated in every industry on Earth. As this diagram shows, it has affected everything that we do already. What are the types of artificial intelligence? First, we might see weak AI, this being non-sentient machine intelligence. This is typically focused on a narrow task, such as what we would see in Siri or Google speaking. Then there's strong AI, which is sentient machine, that is with consciousness and mind. Believe it or not, but Sophia is considered to have weak artificial intelligence. AI may also be seen in four different types. Type 1 AI would be reactive machines. Type 2 AI is limited memory. Type 3 AI is theory of mind. And then type 4 AI is self-awareness. Let's look at these in more detail.
Type 1 AI reactive machines is the most basic type of AI systems, that they are purely reactive. They do not have the ability to form memories, nor use the past experiences to inform current decisions. A good example of this would be seen in Deep Blue. This was IBM's chess-playing supercomputer. It actually beat an international grandmaster in the game in the late 1990s. Deep Blue could identify the pieces on a chessboard and know each of the moves. It can make predictions about what moves might be next for it and its opponent, and it can choose the most optimal moves from amongst all the possibilities. But it does not have any concept of the past, nor any memory of what has happened before, apart from a rarely used chess-specific rule against repeating the same move three times. Deep Blue ignores everything before the present moment. All it can do is look at the pieces on the chessboard as it stands at the present moment, and then it chooses the best possible move. Many argue that this is the only type of machine that we should build, because this type of intelligence involves the computer perceiving the world directly and acting upon what it sees. It doesn't rely on an internal concept of the world. These types of machines are designed and programmed for one specific task at hand. This is a very narrow view, but it is the simplest of all AI systems. They will never get bored or interested or sad or have a motive to take over the world. Type 2 AI is limited memory. Now, we see this kind in self-driving cars. They use their limited memory to remember such things as the things that are in their environment. This may be curves in the road, other cars that are around them, street markings, traffic signals, and lane marking. This is all included in the computer's memory so they can make a good decision when to change lane, slow down, or speed up. But all of these pieces of information about its past are only transient. They aren't saved as part of the car's library of experience it can learn from, the same way that human drivers compile experience over years behind the wheel. Next is Type 3 AI, or Theory of Mind. These are highly advanced machines indeed, for not only can they form representations about the world, but also about other agents or beings in the world. Theory of mind is very crucial to how humans interact with each other, because we have to understand that others have motives, intentions, and without taking these into account, it's almost impossible to work with each other. Now, if artificial intelligence systems are indeed ever to work among us, they have to be able to understand that each person has thoughts and feelings and also expectations of how we are to be treated, and they have to adjust their behavior according to those things. The last type is Type 4 AI, self-awareness. This form of AI actually has self-awareness, which goes beyond just theory of mind, but actually a consciousness and is self-aware. Believe it or not, but there's other ways that we can divide artificial intelligence. This is looking at how the artificial intelligence is actually derived from. One is that everything is programmed. This is the way it's been done in the past, and most of the machines that we see today are actually done this way. Now, this is also the safest way to create artificial intelligence, because the programmer has control of exactly what goes on as far as the intelligence. The second way is self-learning machines. This is new and is actually occurring now, with different researchers actually experimenting with machines that learn. And the third type is copy of human mind, where a person actually copies their human mind into a computer system. The first time this happens, many questions will arise. For example, do they have the same human rights as the person did who uploaded their mind to the machine? And how will people treat an android that has a human mind? Well, that was my introduction to my new series all on artificial intelligence. I worked on this for 2 days, so please give it a like, comment down below, and share. And I'd also like to say a special thank you on all the researchers and authors who have been working on the subject of artificial intelligence. Thank you again, and bye-bye.